Hello, Bozeman. How you doing tonight? Woo! All right. Terrific. Our topic today, thank you, is connect agility. Our ability to understand and connect easily with others different from us. So research is showing that we are hardwired for connection and that it's good for us. It gives us meaning, keeps us happy and healthy physically and mentally. Gallup surveys show that support and love from others is key to our well-being. And yet, out of 50 states, guess where Montana ranks, you guys? Close, 33, behind Delaware, for crying out loud, okay? So heck, we can do better than that, can't we? Yeah, all right. So, you know, our diverse workplaces, our world, and our home Bozeman challenges us to connect with people who are new and different. Ages, backgrounds, self-expression, lifestyle. Well, you know, but today connecting is on the wane because our friends and family scatter and we choose high tech over high touch interaction. Our busy lives put connection on the back burner and, you know, we stick with people who we are familiar and comfortable with rather than making new room for others. For 20 years, my work has been to help people be better leaders at work. I have trained and coached folks from in every state, from accountants to cement workers, all with different worldviews. But I can attest to the benefits of connecting, which include, for example, different but interesting perspectives, new ideas, stimulation, and being heard and seen, sharing, empathy, love, respect. So, you know, sharpening, testing, broadening our thinking and decision making. So that's how a type A gal from New York, like me, ended up in Kansas coaching 45 construction workers, team workers, on leadership. Do you love my 80s shoulder pads? Sure, we were from very different worlds, and it took time for us to build mutual respect and trust, but in 6 months, they were better team leaders, and I made some lifelong friends. So they shared their ideas of a close family, community, home with me in a way I'd never experienced. Loyalty, patience, unconditional love. It was fantastic. So, how about you? When was the last time that you felt that positive surge of energy connecting with someone who was interesting, but maybe a little irritating because they didn't remind you of you? So, tips from the road. First, try not to be a grouch. Your friends and family will tell you, right? You know, practice expanding your heart. It's a muscle. Let's exercise it. Just a little warning, you might need to relax your personal opinions in order to really connect with that other person. So what are your personal biases? Are you a strong pro, like dog versus cat person? Are you, you know, beer versus wine? How about that controversial under versus over issue? Okay, my pet peeve, potato versus potato. All right, so let's not, you know, focus on our differences. Okay, but be curious about that other person, all right? Let's look to connect and collaborate and try not to write them off or convert them. For example, you know, in my work with leaders, we can choose two groups of people who are considered different and see how to better connect with them, introverts and women. All right, yeah, right? So the research shows that these folks don't always get a fair shake at work because, you know, they don't really fit into our mainstream cultural ideal. Now, we know that we can't all fit into that, you know, charismatic football hero type. So how do we fit in? Well, in her book on introverts called Quiet, Susan Cain busts the myths. Sure, next to outgoing extroverts, your introverts are going to, you know, not be crazy about like chatter or conflict and take a little more time making decisions. But it doesn't mean that they are antisocial or passive. Often they're, you know, really deep thinkers, given a little time, come up with an even better solution. Did you guys know that about a third of us here are introverts? Yay! If you are, woo! All right. and that each of us certainly has introvert and extrovert qualities. And famous introverts include people like Einstein, Rosa Parks, Michael Jordan. Closer to home, how do I, an extrovert mom, connect with my introvert daughter, who's a bookworm and loves her privacy? You know, in a nutshell, I try not to judge her needs, and I create space for her to excel on her own terms. And that's it. On to our second group, women. All right, our world has been shaped, you know, and led mainly by men. Maybe that's why research shows that even today, both men and women find successful men likable, but successful women unlikable. You know, no wonder gals have a harder time, you know, getting ahead. And this, despite the fact that tons of research shows that it's the feminine leadership qualities, okay, that help produce teams, okay, that are very effective. Skills like listening, checking your ego at the door, collaboration, ethics, valuing work-life balance, and defying the odds. But maybe it's not so much about whether the guys or the gals are in charge, you know. Maybe it's more about us and our society, our culture, having equal respect for feminine and masculine qualities. After all, each of us here has some of both inside. So finally, three tips to take home with. Let's just commit to putting one of them into action right now. First, see our differences as strengths. Yeah. Second, let's be open to feedback and learning more about ourselves. And third, you be the first one to reach out and connect. Thank you very much. Good night.